Vanderbilt's Kumar Rocker all smiles after no-hitting Duke with 19 strikeouts in Game 2 on Saturday, forcing a winner-take-all Game 3 in Nashville. Duke looking to advance to its first College World Series appearance since 1961. But Mason Hickman, Vandy's starter on Sunday, picking up right where Rocker left off, getting two strikeouts to start the top of the first, and then gets Matt Mervis looking to strike out the side. Meanwhile, in the bottom of the first inning, on the second pitch of the frame, Austin Martin lifts one out to left center field for a solo shot. Commodores get on the board first, and they weren't done in the opening frame. Now with runners on the corners and one out, Pat DeMarco absolutely demolishes that offering on a 2-0 count. It's a three-run shot. Vanderbilt starts the first inning with a 4-0 advantage. Bottom of the second now. Martin at it again. This time, lifting one over the left field wall for a two-run homer. His second in as many innings as he joins DeMarco with three RBIs on the day. Vanderbilt up 6-0. And the power surge just getting started. Bottom of the fourth, it's 9-2 Vanderbilt. And the lefty, Steven Scott, with a solo homer. This one just barely creeps over the wall to give Vanderbilt double digits. It's 10-2. And then in the bottom of the fifth, bases empty for Julian Infante, who goes opposite field, a laser to right center. The Commodores ended up with five home runs in the ball game. And then closing it out in the ninth, up 13-2, Tyler Brown, a little heat to end the game. Vanderbilt wins the game, wins the series, and advances to the College World Series.